today. From Hard Rock Stadium in Miami, Florida, this is Madden NFL 21. We'll see Tua Tagovailoa and the Miami Dolphins taking on Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons.
While much of the country is struggling under cold temps and some of that white stuff, no such troubles here at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the sight of their Dolphins emerging from the Hard Rock Stadium tunnels, and we are ready to go as the Dolphins get set to match up with Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons. Charles and I have been looking forward to this one all week, and we are underway from Hard Rock Stadium. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Dolphins now taking the field, led by the 5th overall pick back in April out of Alabama, quarterback Tua Tagovailoa.
And I'm not sure what the proper term is, whether things just actually worked out. The universe spoke serendipity, but you remember, all through 2019, everyone was talking about Tua Tagovailoa going to the Dolphins in the draft, and many thought that was lost when the Dolphins actually won a few games at the end of the season. But Tua still went to them at number 5, and he has fit in perfectly, exactly what they've been looking for at the quarterback position.
On play action, here's Tua. He'll get this into the hands of Breida. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Well, Matt Breida actually had the fastest play of 2019, hitting 22.3 miles an hour on an 83-yard touchdown run, and he was moving here too.
And we talk so much from a defensive perspective about scheming and finding ways to take away the run. That means the offense has to devise different ways to get the ball in the hands of their guy out of the backfield. Find open space, let him run, and big things can happen, and they did right there.
And his top speed, as computed by Next Gen Stats, not bad. He was pushing 20 miles an hour. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's the first carry from Matt Breida. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. That play doomed from the start thanks to the defensive effort of Grady Jarrett.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
On second down, Tua. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 15 yards on the play. First down.
Today's football, the receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage. When you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
On first down, here's Breida. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
He's going to go for a big play downfield. And nearly an interception here on their opening drive. But instead, third down.
I'm looking at this one with my defensive eyeglasses on, because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 17 yards for the Dolphins there as they've got themselves a first down. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Going to throw right side here, complete. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Tua going to hand this one to Breida. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. From the gun, it's Tua. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, like hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They run for it with Breida. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. 4 yards on the pickup. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks.
Well, that's what's called being aggressive right there. But I don't know that it's reckless. I think it's much more of a message, hey, defense, I believe in you in case we don't get it. And offense, trying to let him know he believes in them as well.
I like it. Your first drive of the game in plus territory, be aggressive. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
On second down, a run with Breida. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at 6.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Got his man on the out route. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
Brian Flores learned under the master. He's going to go on fourth down. Now the former Cal Bear, it's Patrick Laird. And this is going to be nowhere close. Needed some inches and ended up losing yardage. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. So here the Falcons now as they get set for their opening possession. They'll be led out by their 35-year-old quarterback in his 13th season in the NFL, the former MVP Matt Ryan.
This past offseason was one where the Atlanta organization continued to build around their quarterback Matt Ryan because he can still throw the rock. Fifth in the NFL in passing yards last year with better than 4,400. He's a guy who knows how to get the ball to his guys on the perimeter and take care of it, even when he's under duress in the pocket. Sacked 48 times last year.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and six.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want, but on the defensive side of the ball, you're scrambling a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Here's Ryan. And he hits his target. This is Luke Stocker. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Open receiver, that's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. I know it's an emotional game, Charles. You can't do that.
And when you get into your film sessions and you argue your case with your coaches, that's exactly what they say at the end. You just can't do it. It costs your team.
Penalty. It's Gurley. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Out on the edge. You love to have cornerbacks like that that can bring him down in the run game.
And you're also exposed to everyone. It really becomes a one-on-one play, doesn't it? You're out there by yourself on the edge. The best ones know how to make the play, and we just saw an example of it right there.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. From the gun, it's Ryan. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. Score after 1 on EA Sports. a catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. From the shotgun, Ryan. So Miami coming out for their second drive. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit. They're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. And that one heck of a run right there. Once he got loose, you could tell that he was going to run a long way. That was pretty impressive.
And first and foremost, this is all about vision. He could see the play developing right in front of him. And once he's past the line of scrimmage and got a full head of steam behind him, he's just going to keep right on going.
And the numbers here don't lie. According to the Next Gen stats, he topped out at an even 22 miles an hour. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Now Tua. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A gain of six there on first.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. From midfield, here's Tua. He's going to float this one deep right side. Oh, now Breida loses it, and this is going to get out of bounds through the end zone, and that will go as a turnover as the defense will get it at the 20-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Operating from the gun, Ryan. It's complete. This is Todd Gurley. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage. And that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first. And that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
On first down, it's Gurley. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Good tackle for the loss there by Kyle Van Noy, and he had his best years in New England. Led him in combined tackles in 2018, and they won the Super Bowl at the conclusion of that season. Miami certainly hopes he can help. A defense that ranked 30th in yards allowed per game last year, they certainly hope he can lead and continue to show plays like that.
They've got second and 12 from the 36. From the gun, Ryan. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bobby McCain. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
Miami set to take over. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. After the turnover, it's Tua. His throw incomplete. The intended receiver was Jakeem Grant, and that'll bring up second down.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
This is Breida on the draw. Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against him.
The Dolphins on third down, just one for three thus far. This is third and seven. Looking to pass, Tua. It's complete to Graham. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down.
You always worry about those smaller receivers running through that gnarly patch of land in the middle of the field. But he did a really nice job there holding on to the football and protected himself as best he could while completing the play.
Second quarter, 2 minutes remain, 3-0 our score. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, run that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do. I believe I'm following their logic. Take the big shot downfield, loosen things up. You're hoping to get some points on the board before the half. Maybe now you come back and throw some underneath stuff in order to make sure you get a completion.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Allen Bailey just would not be denied. That's a loss of seven.
And that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a third and long. And it's caught by Parker. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up the first and goal. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not. Well, they were coming out of the field defensively. Pressure coming off the right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
First down, a bit of a disaster. And now on second and goal, back even further. Tua sets up to pass it. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Two are going to throw. Completes it to the tight end, Smythe. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. So on fourth down, Dolphin kicker Jason Sanders comes on. Sanders' kick is good, and the Dolphins are going to tie the score at 3. So 3 drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
So if you're an offensive coordinator and you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong line of work, aren't you? You got to find a way to unlock the key to these defenses and put some big points on the board.
Field goals, all we've had so far. 3-3 now as the kick is away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. Matt Ryan and the offense heading back onto the field. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. A very quick pass to Ridley. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Operating from the gun, Ryan. And he's going to have the hook up to Gage. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 7 yards there and a first down.
Come on, what are we doing? Step your game up.
Falcons going to use their 3rd and final timeout. As the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. From the gun, Ryan. And he gets this one to Ridley, complete. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. So we've reached halftime at a low-scoring affair, just a pair of field goals. 3-3 is our score. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Not too much to show you scoring-wise in that first half. Just a couple of field goals make up all the scoring. But the teams are ready to go at half number 2.